So we will start with the spin half particle again. And what we will discuss an example that if we measure Sx on a particle in a general state, which is chi equal A chi plus and B chi minus. You remember that chi plus is the spin up state and chi minus is the spin down state. While A is the amplitude, A is the coefficient, which will give us the probability, and B is another amplitude of the spin down. What result will you get? If you measure Sx, means which is one of the component of the spin angular momentum on this state, then what result will you get? This means to find the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of Sx. So we will have to find them. Now to solve this thing, first we know that what is Sx. We have derived this earlier, that Sx is h bar over 2, 0, 1, and 1, 0. This is our Sx. So we will have to find the very first thing which is written here is that we will have to find the eigenvalues. So let's start by first starting with eigenvalues. You know that the eigenvalue problem is that you will have to take determinant and then Sx minus lambda I. This is the characteristic equation of any eigenvalue problem. This is your identity matrix. Lambda is your eigenvalue. And from your operator, you will subtract this and you will take determinant. And this will give you the eigenvalues. This implies that what it will be, h bar over 2, if you multiply, then this will become h bar over 2, this will become h bar over 2. Now multiply this with lambda I, this is the identity matrix. And identity matrix, you know that it is 1, 0, 0, 1. So from this you will subtract minus lambda times I. So what it will be? Let me write this, that it will be a determinant. And a determinant of what? This will be the matrix. So let me write it like this, that it will be a determinant. And it will be 0, h bar over 2, and h bar over 2, and 0. So this is your one matrix minus, when lambda will be multiplied here with I, then it will be lambda and 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So we will have to write for 1, this one, and then this will be equal to 0. And hence our equation will become the determinant. So I will now write it like this, minus lambda, the very first here component, minus lambda, then h bar over 2 minus 0, and then h bar over 2 here, and minus lambda again, and this thing is equal to 0. I have just subtracted this thing. So minus minus determinant, you will have to expand this one, minus into minus plus, and you are having lambda square. Then minus h bar square over 4. So h bar square over 4, and this is equal to 0. And this implies that lambda is plus minus h bar over 2. So you got two values of lambda, means you found two eigenvalues which are associated with Sx in a general state, which we will now address. Then there are two eigenvalues, plus h bar by 2 and minus h bar over 2. Now the corresponding eigenfunctions, how we will find them? These are the eigenfunctions of SX. We know that we are getting one is chi plus and another is chi minus. These are the spin up and spin down states, means the eigenstates. So the these eigenfunctions, when I will find them for SX, I will put a label X here and here. This will show me that they are the eigenfunctions of SX, right? So let's start with this one. The very first way we determine, first one, and this is lambda 1 equals when the eigenvalue is h bar over 2, then this implies that SX will operate on chi plus X. This will give you this eigenvalue h bar over 2 and chi plus X. This will be your equation. And now you will have to put the matrices. So SX, and then this, let's say I consider that this is alpha beta, which will be equal to h bar over 2 alpha beta. So I will have to find the values of alpha and beta, and this will give me the matrix. This will give me the eigenfunctions of SX in matrix form. So put the value of SX. And SX, you know this is h bar over 2 and 0, 1, 1, 0. And this is equal, means it is multiplied with alpha and beta, which is a column matrix, and h bar over 2, alpha and beta. Now when you do multiply it, what you will get? 0 into alpha, so 0. 1 into beta, it will be beta. Beta plus 0. Then alpha plus 0, so it will become alpha. While h bar over 2 is cancelling with h bar over 2. So beta alpha is equal to alpha beta, right? What does this mean? That beta is equal to alpha and alpha is equal to beta. Beta is equal to alpha, alpha is equal to beta. What does it mean? That alpha and beta are the same thing. So I can write that actually alpha and beta are equal. So my matrix will become, what is the matrix? This is the matrix. So alpha and beta matrix actually goes into alpha alpha. Our matrix is not this one. Now we will have to normalize this matrix. As yesterday you have asked that whether they are normalized or not. So we will have to normalize our matrix now. If it is not normalized, then it will not be an eigenfunction. It will not be something which can reside in Hilbert space. So we will have to normalize it. You know normalization, psi conjugate into psi and integral in dx equals 1. In matrices, we don't do integration. We just multiply the conjugate of a matrix with the matrix. And you know how to take conjugate of a matrix. So it will be the, it will be alpha, alpha, and the conjugate of this matrix, then multiplied with the matrix itself, and this will be equal to 1. Now how to take conjugate of a matrix? There are two things involved. First, when you take the conjugate of a matrix, then you take the transpose of it. So the column matrix will convert into a row matrix. That is the transpose. The other thing that you do in conjugate, wherever there is iota involved, you will change the sign of it. It will become minus iota. If it is iota, it will become minus iota. So you change the sign of iota. This implies that this is alpha alpha. Is alpha, no iota is involved here. So it will become alpha alpha. The column matrix will convert into the row matrix. And this will be alpha alpha, and this is equal to 1. Now you can do multiply. Alpha into alpha. Alpha squared. So we are getting alpha squared plus alpha into alpha. Alpha squared is equal to 1. And this implies that alpha is equal to 1 over 2. Because it will become 2 alpha squared, 2 will come here, 1 over 2, then alpha will be equal to 1 over 2 square root. Clear? So, from here, our matrix will become chi plus, and x will become 1 over 2, and alpha alpha. But what is alpha alpha value? From here it says that alpha is, from here it says that beta is equal to alpha, and alpha is equal to beta, and they are normalized. We have normalized them. So it means that this thing is equal 1 over 2. This 1 over 2 normalization can come only if our alpha and beta are 1, 1. So our alpha is 1. This condition also tells you that alpha should be equal to 1. You do normalize, 1 square plus 1 square is equal to 1, so it will be 1 over 2, and this will be your eigenfunction associated with the plus h bar over 2. Then the second situation, when your eigenvalue is minus h bar over 2, then you apply SX on chi, and chi is minus, and this is with x, so it will give you minus h bar over 2 and chi minus x. So now put equations here as well. This implies, now I will write the things quickly. SX is h bar over 2, 0, 1, 1, 0, and then you are having your matrix alpha beta, and this is equal to minus h bar over 2 alpha beta. You do multiply them, then what you will get? H bar over 2 will cancel with h bar over 2. And here this side will be beta and alpha, and this will be equal to minus times alpha beta, which gives you that alpha is equal to minus beta, because minus sign is now here. The only difference between this and this is the minus sign. So alpha is equal to minus delta, and your matrix will become alpha minus beta. So you are having, your matrix is now requires normalization, and for normalization you will take alpha, and then it will be beta here, but you will take the conjugate, so it will convert into rho matrix, and here is alpha, and alpha is equal to minus beta, so I can write minus alpha here, and alpha minus alpha here. This is the normalization, and this is equal to 1, and again you will get that alpha is 1 over 2. So your chi minus with x will become 1 over 2, and alpha, and then minus alpha. Beta is minus alpha. So 1 minus 1. The difference with this one is that it is 1 over 2, 1, 1. This one is 1 over 2 square root 1 minus 1. Now these are different. Chi plus x and chi minus x are different than chi plus and chi minus, because they are 1, 0 and 0, 1. Here you are having your eigenfunctions like this.